BloombergGate hits home. Has Haggerty decided to take everyone down with him, or is he trying to get the heavyweights involved to stop his investigation? Stay tuned. That's from True News from Change, NYC.org. And then he has the article from New York Daily News today. Indicted campaign aide John Haggerty points finger at Mayor Bloomberg's former deputy mayor. Mayor Bloomberg's political mastermind was outed in court papers Friday as the architect of a plan to hide $1.1 million in Election Day poll watching. Indicted campaign aide John Haggerty said in a 41-page motion that former Deputy Mayor Kevin Sheekey convinced Bloomberg to hire the State Independence Party to do monitoring instead of using his own campaign team. The article goes on to say, they have a quote from Wolfson that says, oh, you know, Mike Bloomberg was just making a donation. Okay, let me ask you something. In the history of our country, in the entire country, is there any candidate that the day before the mayoral election or any election, they make $1 million plus donation, they wire it out of their bank account? The New York Times has a piece on the Doe Foundation that they voted to extend term limits, and Bloomberg gave them a big award out of his foundation after the election. And Tom Robbins wrote a piece about Bloomberg's foundation, you know, him, Bloomberg giving charity as a way of, as part of his goal to be president. I recall the New York Times also had a piece about that, actually. That was why Bloomberg was taking his charities from local New York and making it nationwide. Everyone believed it's because he really wanted to be president. He still does. Anybody involved in this, let's see their emails. And Bloomberg doesn't want to turn over his emails. So I said to somebody, well, we need the feds. And they said, what good would the feds do? The feds are supposed to be investigating and handling the slush fund. And so far with city council, the slush fund, all that's come out of it is a bigger burden for taxpayers paying for their city council, Christine Quinn and her staff's top defense attorneys. So there hasn't been any effective prosecution at City Hall, except for Miguel Martinez, who just he caved in and said he was guilty of stealing. But this is extremely disturbing. And why hasn't Bloomberg turned over his emails to Haggerty? 62 emails, he says, that are personal. And I'd like to see everybody else's emails involved in this. I think they all should be seized, from Wolfson to any of the deputy mayors, that if there's anything involving Haggerty. Too bad that we don't have tape recordings of conversations as well. You know, you call 311, everything's tape recorded. Too bad someone wasn't tape recording these people. Oh, and by the way, when it comes to Mike buying a third term and using charities, he didn't even have to do that. He used real estate, New York real estate. So John Sexton at NYU runs down and testifies that Mike Bloomberg has to have a third term. Why? Because NYU is going to do all this continued expansion, and Mike Bloomberg's going to back it, busting through zoning, which is weighing on our infrastructure. You visit the streets of the East Village or the West Village or really anywhere in New York, the streets are shot to hell, the subway system's shot to hell, you know, our bridges need work, but who cared? It's all about people benefiting hugely, charities, organizations, not-for-profits, but they benefit like real estate magnates, you know, or they were paid, or they're just paid off. Thanks for your vote. So it's extremely corrupt. And who's going to investigate it and successfully prosecute this, if at all? But will Haggerty keep on spilling the beans? And is he going to take people down, or are they going to do something to shut him up? And remember, Maura Kinney worked with Haggerty. She got pulled off that to work with Quinn. And then Quinn and Maura Kinney got written up in the New York Times by Dwyer for improprieties, shady behavior, possible intimidation of union members. It's dirty. It all stinks. It just stinks. Something's really wrong.